What happens if? That's the topic of this week's videos. So we're looking at the data of the coffee shop and we're wondering, how are we doing? How is our sales going? So of course, the first thing you're going to do, you look at your data and you insert a pivot table, of course. And what's important here is this time we detick the add data to the data model mark. And I will explain you later why we do that. So we put in all the sales and we put in all the dates. And let's make the sales look like a currency. It looks a bit prettier and it's easier to see what's going on. However, we now have all the sales per day and it's quite hard to see what's happening. So what you can do in a pivot table is group the data in a month, or in this case, we want to have it in a quarter. So we get a nice little overview of the quarters, quarter one, quarter two, quarter three. And this is why we have to untick the tick mark with add data to the data model. For reasons I also don't understand, this grouping feature only works if your data is not in the data model. So we have to deal with that. So what we're going to do now, first let's rename this worksheet, because obviously sheet 2 is not a good name. Let's call this sales target, because that's what we are going to calculate. We have a goal for the sales we want to have per quarter. We have set ourselves the goal to, on average, make $40,000. That's our goal. So how are we doing towards this goal? Are we getting close? In this quarter, quarter four, we have not made any money yet, so let's set it at zero for now. And then we can calculate what is the current average. We take the average of the three quarters that we already have, combined with the fourth quarter that is currently still zero. So you can see we're not there yet with not any sales in the fourth quarter. We're only at 28,000. So the question is, what do we have to make in that fourth quarter in order to hit our average? What do we have to do? What do we have to make up for to get it? So what we could do, of course, is we can calculate this with a formula. We can say, well, I know I need 40,000 every quarter, so 4 times 40,000 is what I have to make for the entire year. And I can deduct what I have already made by summing the three quarters, and then we get the result. 46,000 and something is what we have to make. But this is a lot of work. I have to think about all the formulas I need. And I can let Excel do the thinking for me, because Excel is a little bit better at doing calculations than I am. We can use a function for that called goalSeek, where we will have Excel find a goal for us. This is how it looks like. So we're going to delete these formulas. We don't need them anymore, because we'll do it smarter and more efficient. We go to the Data tab and we click goalSeek. And then Excel will let us pick a cell we want to set. So we're going to say we want to have an average of 40,000, and we will achieve that by changing that cell. We're going to change the quarter four sales, and there it goes, ta-da! The same value, 46,000. But in this case, we didn't need any formulas. We just have Excel calculate what we need to obtain a certain value. We want to have Excel do the thinking for us.